Hello and welcome to This Week on the Outer Banks. I'm Edward, and on behalf of everyone at Twitty & Company, we're excited to have you with us this week. As you prepare for your vacation, we'd like to recommend a few things to see and do while you're here. The Roanoke Island Aquarium in Manio is always a great location to visit. They have a wide variety of fascinating exhibits. During the summer months, they also offer a number of indoor and outdoor activities. Please visit their website for more details. Both the Currituck Beach and the Body Island Lighthouses are also must-sees when on the Outer Banks. For the Currituck Beach Lighthouse, the cost to climb is $10 for ages 4 and up, and they're open 9 to 5 daily. The Body Island Lighthouse is open daily with the first entry at 9 a.m. and the final entry at 5 p.m. Tickets are required for climbing the Body Island Lighthouse and must be purchased online, so check the website for details. I really encourage you to climb. The Village Table and Tavern in Duck will be hosting Maker's Market this Wednesday from 3 to 6 in their outdoor Soundfront Lounge. You'll find local crafts and goods as well as your favorite summertime beverages. If you're looking to catch some live music, we recommend checking out the Beer Garden in Kerala Village or NC Coast Bar and Grill located in Duck and Jack Brown's Beer and Burger Joint in Kittleville Hills. If you're in Kerala, Yoga in the Park at the Whalehead Club is held on Thursdays at 7:30. Don't forget to bring your gear. There's a lot to see and do all over the Outer Banks, and we hope some of these suggestions might give you a taste of what's out there and might even take you someplace new. For more activities and ideas, check us out on Facebook, Instagram, or the Twitty blog. Up next, we're gonna hang out with Susan from Island Bookstore for this week's local business spotlight. So I'm here at Island Bookstore in Duck at Scarborough Fair with Susan.
Hi.
We're talking about books. So Ben, just off camera, who's filming this, is amazed at my geekiness on books because I love books, and if I was on vacation, I would be in a place like this looking for a book. So Susan, tell us a little bit about the store and your locations. And
okay, we have three locations, one in Old Kerala Village, one here in Duck at Scarborough Fair, and then a third one down in Kitty Hawk near the Trio restaurant.
Okay, and so you have a really, I mean, are all of your stories with this kind of selection of books?
Yeah, they're packed. And that's one of the things that I try really hard to kind of curate a good selection. I like to say we have one of everything, but just one. But we do special orders and we also ship. So we've had several people come in and buy a load of books and we ship them home. So they're there on their arrival. But I think what people find is independent bookstores are rare. And so we have a lot of customers that come in and say, we don't have a store like this within 100 miles of where I live. And so this is a nice destination place since you're in a community vacationing with a bookstore.
And I would even add that, you know, a lot of folks, a lot of you that come on vacation are interested in the area. You have a connection to the Outer Banks, to Kerala, Duck, Manio, wherever it might be. And we're actually standing right next to an area of the store that is full of local books. A couple that have just been released that I was thumbing through this morning, and so a great selection of that.
Yeah.
Do you have a book or anything you might recommend?
Well, honestly, I would recommend all the local books that came out this summer. I think we had four different author signings at our stores this summer with books written by either local authors or about the area. One by a Mr. Clark Twitty, which was pretty awesome. But we have had an uptick in interest in the area. I think it's a time in the evolution of this area that there's a ton of history books being published, but popular history with lots of photographs and things like that.
Well, Susan, thanks for coming over here before you even open to be with us. There's a great breakfast place next door called Treehouse right here in Scarborough Fair that we might go visit after this. But really great spot here. If you're on the Outer Banks, you're looking for a good book to read while you're sitting on the beach or whatever you might be doing, this is a great spot to come and check out. So thanks for joining us for this week on the Outer Banks, and we'll see you next week.
Bye.